A very good morning from Aruba. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to this walk video. We will be walking from the Tamarijn to the Divi Beach.
Yep.
And hope you enjoyed this one. Part of the idea of this video is to take a look at the Tamarijn Beach, not officially called the Tamarijn Beach, but to take a look at the conditions of it after the storm passed. We didn't feel that much of an effect, but there are high winds and somewhat high waves. You have been with the kids swimming at the Divi Beach recently, and it has been, according to you, a little bit more wavy than the usual.
Yeah, more waves, a little bit more circusism.
Okay.
But no, it's definitely still beautiful.
So yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Let's not take too long and let's start our walk this morning. And we can notice, so we are walking from, let's see, this is the easternmost part of the Tamarijn Resort, which we start looking at. And the beach this morning, apparently, they did go over it with some probably beach cleaning, beach repairing type of vehicle or something, right? So we can see it like it's marked. And we're gonna go over the board and walk till the end, and maybe a little bit of the Divi Beach, depending on the conditions that we see. It's a beautiful, beautiful morning. You see folks taking care of the sargassum here, so they are trying to take care of that. And the Tamarijn is definitely one of those resorts that you are staying so very close to the water. But over the last couple of years, it's been an on and off. And especially lately, the beach has been struggling. You know, it's not what it used to be. And that's why we make these videos on occasion every couple of months, so folks can compare. And for me personally, I mean, apart from some sargassum that's definitely to be seen, as Marlene mentioned, so this part is quite a bit. The other thing that I noticed are the sandbags that they have now here to try to break. So the way to put it, they don't put it straight out, they put it diagonal, so it starts to break and doesn't affect the beach too much. Or at least that's the intention. That's not always the result. Let me know in the comments below if you have ever stayed here. I know many times folks click on the video because they are interested in knowing what's going on. Either they've stayed here before, they're a fan of the Tamarijn, or maybe they have a trip planned in the future, and maybe even near future. We know that the school vacation is coming up soon. And here we can see some of the sargassum. Well, actually, I think actually that's not sargassum, quite frankly. Now that I take a kind of a better look, I think it's seagrass.
Yeah.
There is somewhat of a difference, of course. And this is probably just caused by Tropical Storm Brett that passed near Aruba recently. And that's quite close. We did have some rain, some downpour in the early morning hours, and but it wasn't anything bad. We did go check out the waves on the north shore.
Yeah.
later that day, and that was pretty impressive how large the waves were. You definitely, if we can just briefly stop, you can definitely notice the water being quite choppy.
Yeah.
And for me personally, like, swimming here would not be all that recommended.
No.
You know, you could, but it doesn't look that great, to be honest. And of course, that's, you know, like, the folks ask me sometimes, like, wow, but why did they make this resort, this hotel, this property so close to the water? And when I take a look at photos from the past and from what I can remember from my childhood, I remember we used to come here quite often to this beach and swim around here. And the beach was definitely wider, so it is not what it used to be. This is the bunker bar, and there's a story behind it, and it goes way back to the Second World War. If you did not know about it. So yeah, this area used to be like a refinery area, believe it or not, in the 40s, 50s or so, and certainly during the Second World War. And that bunker bar is part of history. So if you are having a drink there is like somewhere you can read more about the specific history of it. If you are looking for a place to stay where you can open your sliding door and hear the waves crashing,
yeah.
That's, oh, look, Marilyn, your favorite, the pelican. Oh, it's just standing there. Marilyn's a big fan of pelicans. And one of the reasons you always tell me that no pelicans in Holland.
No.
So we are used to them. So to me, it was just a bird. And then I realized, well, they are kind of like special bird. This one is probably ready to fly away in just a bit. But we can take this opportunity also to look back a little bit and see what's going on at the beach here at the Tamarijn. So near the bunker bar, basically no swimming. Look at how rocky it is, how much, unfortunately, it has eroded. And it was doing much better, maybe up to a couple of months ago. And I know a lot of folks keep telling me to check back, do another video on it because they've heard this or that. And that's what we are doing this morning. Hope you're enjoying this video so far. And if you are enjoying it, consider giving it a like, that helps a lot with the algorithm of it and the channel in general. And in case you're not subscribed, click that subscribe button. I have a lot of videos on Aruba if that's what you're looking for, and an occasional travel video every so often. It's a little bit I was telling them that it's a little bit sad to see the beach again, like eroded, mm-hmm. and with so many rocks. It was doing a little bit better a few months ago after the tough hurricane season we had late last year. We had like three storms passing by fairly close and fairly, you know, serious storms. And who knows now when it will recover again. It's gonna take some time again to recover from this one. And these are not damages per se from the recent storm per se, but it didn't help either. that's the thing. I always love to come to the beach early in the morning because it's so quiet, so peaceful.
I just wanted to say,
yeah,
so quiet.
You can hear yourself walking and breathing. Well, in the afternoon, oftentimes it can get quite busy. Here we are getting closer and closer to the area where the restaurant is, etc. Of the Tamarijn, of course. And I remember the last video we made here. I remember folks swimming here. Maybe Marlene, she's coming up. Maybe Marlene remembers. The last video we filmed here, I think Boaz was with us.
Oh, yeah.
And Boaz, our son, and I remember some folks swimming here, mm-hmm. right, like this part, and now it's, you still could, but the beach itself is very small now.
Yeah.
Ah, should we have breakfast? Smells good. We haven't had yet. I haven't even had, I think you haven't either, coffee. So, yeah. Hello. Good morning. It seems like they have like a new section here. I think this part. I don't remember it being this big. It's on this stretch. We can also notice that it's mostly rocks, so not as good for swimming. Let's take a brief look at the swimming pool, the Tamarijn swimming pool, and they got the bar over on the other side. And it looks like a nice small, well, not that small actually, but a low-rise, nice low-rise, yeah. Property, most definitely. Nice size swimming pool.
Lots of view here with the palm trees on the beach there.
Yeah, yeah.
I love this view.
Yeah. And if I start noticing on the Divi side, so the Divi Beach, which is this one, just from the looks of it, it looks like the beach has also lost some terrain, yeah. again, yeah. unfortunately. So most of what I can see from already, like a couple of 100 meters maybe, there are rocks on the beach side, so basically no swimming on this side. And then that means that you still have a good option here at the Divi Beach. And that should be okay. You can also swim on the other side, so where we started. I do see a lot of locals swimming there. Not the best beach on the island, but it's okay. If you don't like crowded beaches, it's definitely an option. So this will give you an idea how high the descent used to be going down, and now it's dug up all of the sand, and they'll have to again put some fill it up with sand, because this is not going to recover by itself, not at the Tamarijn. At the Divi Beach it does, it can, but here at the Tamarijn very difficult. Very, very difficult, unfortunately. I think these are also new here. So this one and this area, I don't remember seeing it. I didn't notice it. We do come here like kind of fairly often, at least to the Divi Beach. And oh my God, look at that again. Oh, that's so sad. That is so sad. Wow. That is not good news. That is not good news. Oh man. But further up, you do have, a beach where you can go swimming. But it's very unfortunate. And in this area alone, you have the Tamarijn, you have the Divi Dutch Village, you have the Divi Resort, and also the golf resort. So quite a few folks staying here in this area. Wow, this breaks my heart.
Yeah, I was here the last week. A few times with the kids.
Yeah.
But it's more damaged than a few days ago.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
These
are basically conditions we had in October or so last year. Wow. Let's walk a little bit further. So for those who are not familiar with it, maybe you are doing, as I said, research. Normally you would walk here on the sand and start walking on the beach completely. And where you see the first maybe 10 feet of water, 10, 15 feet would be the beach. And right now it's not so, and these things take quite a bit to recover, and with one storm or one high tide or some choppy waves or something can change the whole story again. And if you look at the water where it is here till where the pathway and where these golf carts go by, swimming meters, I would say like 4 max 5 meters, that'd be like 10 to 15 feet more or less. So that's quite alarming again. I'm not trying to be alarming on my channel, but yeah, this is what it is, unfortunately. And the Divi is definitely one of the most beautiful beaches, but it is affected quite often. And I've explained it also in other videos, but the reason it is affected is that, let me turn the camera around so you guys can see us. So the reason it's affected is that when you take the map of Aruba, it is situated more or less on the south side of the island. And with that, it gets the waves from the south side, coming from the south. While let's say Manchebo Beach and Eagle Beach and Palm Beach and Arashi and all of those other ones, they get the waves from the west side. The normal condition would be waves from the northeast. And when the weather changes, you get this. It starts coming from the south, and these are the beaches that get usually the hardest hit. Unless it gets, the winds are turned, the wind and the waves are turned around and it comes directly from the west. That does happen sometimes, but on Eagle Beach, you basically never see this. On Palm Beach, not either. I don't recall seeing this bad ever, but it can get a little bit bad. So that's more or less the situation from here. As far as sargassum or seagrass, I don't see anything over there. Maybe they have cleaned it up, maybe. I do see some folks further up swimming, so that's nice. But for this one, we will be wrapping up. Maybe you have something to add to the video?
No, it's still beautiful.
It's still beautiful, most definitely. Yeah. Definitely over here. Just unfortunate, and the trees are getting a ride this morning and checking out the beach. Anyway, guys, I'm not taking more of your time. Hope you enjoyed this video.
Yes.
For me and Marlene, it's been a pleasure, and hope to see you in the next one.
Yes.
Bye bye, guys.